Do you see this right here? This major, huge scratch? Yeah, this probably could have been avoided if we had known a few things about the campground and the campsite where this happened. Stay tuned, and I'm gonna tell you a little story.
We are Charity, Ben, Dakota, and Trinity. We decided we didn't want to wait for a life of adventure. So in 2017, we bought our first RV and set off to live a life of travel in the USA. We've visited over 38 states in 3 years and have many more to go. Follow along to learn all the best places to see, RV and travel tips, and much more.
So welcome back to the channel, everyone. We named our channel Grateful Glamper because we are very grateful to be living RV life. And we do like to practice gratitude on a daily basis. And one thing that we always like to do is just invite you to do the same and drop a comment below and let us know what you're thankful for today if you so desire. So before that we jump into today's video and I tell you more about how this huge deep gouge got into our RV, we want to give a quick thank you to all of our Grateful Glamper insiders. We really appreciate your support month in and month out. It helps us to keep videos like this coming to you week in and week out. Plus, we've got some insiders only perks. So you can check out our insiders at the link below on Patreon. So now let me tell you a little story about campers and big rigs and rocks. So we have a motorhome that is about 40 feet in length. And I know some of you have faced similar challenges regardless of the size of your particular motorhome or RV, travel trailer, whatever it may be. And that is, there can be objects, rocks, trees, cement pylons that are, you know, like 2 feet off the ground or maybe 3 feet off the ground, and they're not super visible. And let me ask you this too. Have you had the same struggle that we have had, where you are looking for a campsite and then you show up to this campsite that you booked on, you know, maybe recreation.gov or a state park website, and you realize, oh my gosh, I am not sure how we're gonna get into this campsite because of some of these different objects that are in the way. So that is exactly how this gouge happened on the side of our motorhome when my husband, who is amazing, he is an amazing driver. He has backed us in and out of hundreds of campsites over the last 4 years, but there was a rock that was about 2 feet high that was not super visible. And we went to go take a corner and gouged the side of our basement compartment. We have been on the hunt for a better way when it comes to trying to figure out this whole thing of campsites and ways that we can make sure before we even get to a campground that, first of all, we can maneuver around said campground fairly easy. We've actually been talking to some other people in the RV community and our other RV friends, and we've heard dozens of stories within the last couple of months of fellow RVers that booked a site at an RV park, went to pull in and realized, I can't even bank around this corner. Or maybe there was such a severe dip going in to the campground that they knew that they would bottom out, or their tow vehicle would bottom out, or something would happen where they just were not going to even be able to turn into the campground and had to call and cancel their reservation and find someplace else to camp. Because so many of these types of campgrounds, it's very hard to know before you go how much room you're gonna have, especially from a maneuverability standpoint, to know if you're gonna be able to maneuver your RV, your travel trailer, your fifth wheel around corners, to be able to back in, especially when there's other campers or trucks and things parked in these rows of campers. I mean, if you've been living RV life for any length of time, you have to drop me a comment below, because I'm sure every single one of you have some sort of story where you have had the struggle, because hashtag the struggle is real, folks, when you're out there RVing. So we were recently introduced to this tool called Campground Views that I am just super stoked about. And we do want to thank Campground Views and Mark at Campground Views for sponsoring today's video. But let me tell you why I'm so excited about this, because this is going to be a game changer for us in all of our trip planning moving forward. Campground Views is like Google Street View for camping. Let me tell you why that this is so super important and why I'm so super excited about this. Case in point, Yellowstone National Park, where we visited this summer. We had an amazing campsite in the Gallatin National Forest right outside of West Yellowstone. Now, this is one of those campsites that you have to book at least 6 months in advance through recreation.gov. If you have booked any campsites through recreation.gov, you know that when you go to book, all that you see is a very cryptic map that shows you some loop numbers and then some campsites within those loop numbers. There is no way to be able to really get a good idea of how big the campsite is other than the cryptic measurements they give you. But even at that, you don't know if there's objects next to the campsite. You just know it's X amount of feet long. There's so many things you don't know. If there's a tree right next to your campsite that's gonna inhibit you from putting out your slides that you need to put out. All you can see is these loops, these campsites along these loops. Pick the one you want. And I always feel like I'm playing Russian roulette, like spinning the wheel, hoping that I just magically pick the best one that's gonna be the best fit for our particular application. So with Campground Views, they have mapped out the majority of campsites that you can book on recreation.gov with like a Google Street View. This is amazing because you can see, are there trees? Are there rocks? Are there objects in these campsites that are going to be prohibitive for putting out your slides or for accessing your basement compartments? It was not fun this summer when we were staying in Yellowstone and I'm trying to run our business while we're on the road and do shipping, and I have all of my shipping supplies in one of our basement compartments, and I couldn't open my basement compartment because there was a big rock in the way. So every time I need to open my basement compartment, I have to partially close my slide. Go out, open my basement compartment, get what I need, close it, come back in, put the slide back out every stinking time because there's a big rock in the way. And there were so many other campsites that we saw along these loops that would have been so much better for our rig, that would have maybe been better access to where that the water spigots were, or closer to the dump station where maybe we could have used our macerator and not had to worry about the whole storage tank situation. I mean, just better sites in general, right? But I have no way of knowing that just looking at the recreation.gov map. That's why I'm so excited about Campground Views, because I can totally now see how each of these sites look. I can see if there's things in the way before I choose the site that I want to book. One note on trip planning. Guys, this video is gonna be out in September. A lot of these sites that are on recreation.gov or through state parks, you need to book 6 months in advance. That means this December, January, you need to start booking. So you only have just a few months to think about where you're wanting to go next summer and what sites that you wanna book and stay at. So it's a perfect time to jump in on a Campground Views membership so that you can see these sites to make sure that you get the site that you want this summer. So while you're considering trip planning, we did also want to make you aware that I have a free trip planning template. Now, this is the template that I use for our trip planning, and you can get that for free at gratefulglamper.com/planner. We'll put a link below, but we'll also put a link above. I have a whole video I did that gives you kind of a step-by-step walkthrough of how that I use this particular planning template and some extra trip planning tips and tricks. Another thing that I absolutely love about Campground Views is that Campground Views was actually founded and owned by a fellow full-time RVer. So somebody else that is like walking the same path that we all walk and facing the same struggles that we all face. And Mark, who owns Campground Views, realized this was a big problem for them in knowing, can they fit into spaces? Can they back into spaces? And so I love being able to take these types of tools that have been created by fellow RVers in the RV community. And let's face it, the RV community, you guys out there, everybody is so supportive of one another. And so anytime that we can partner with somebody else that's in the RV community, we love those types of partnerships. So we were super excited to be able to have them sponsor this video and just support Mark in what he's doing, but also because we were super excited about being able to use this tool to plan our stuff for the summer moving forward. So a lot of people think that you're not gonna be able to fit a big rig in any of the national park campgrounds or the campsites that you can book through recreation.gov. We've stayed in Zion National Park. We stayed in the National Forest outside of Yellowstone. There are dozens and dozens of national park campsites that you can fit big rigs in. And being able to use campground views can really help you to make sure that as you go to look at those sites, that you're reserving the best one that's going to fit your rig perfectly. Now, even if you don't have a big rig, even if you have a travel trailer or a pop-up or a fifth wheel, using this particular tool is very useful because let's just face it, there are some sites that are gonna maybe fit a travel trailer better than others, or maybe that opens up more variety for you, but you can still make sure that you have got the primo site before that you go to book. So I'm curious about some of your experiences in the comments below, as far as have you ever booked a campsite, especially at a state park or through a website like recreation.gov, and you get there and you're just a little bit on the disappointed side with how the site is or the ease of backing in? Or have you ever had to do like some of our friends have had to do in the RV community and realize you can't even get into the site and just have to leave and find someplace else to camp? You'll have to let me know in the comments below what some of your experiences with this have been, because we're curious, but we also really enjoy hearing from you and hearing your stories as far as what sort of things that you run into out there when you're RVing. You'll also have to let us know in the comments below, what are some of the things that you would like to see in future videos? Do you want to see more RV maintenance tips? Do you want to see tutorials? Do you want to see mods and hacks? What is it that you would like to see more of when it comes to RV videos? Let us know below, because we're always looking for your feedback to make sure that the content that we're bringing to you is exactly what you want when you want it. So let us know in the comments below. I don't even know what it's going to take to fix this. I mean, this is really deep. Like, do you hear it? Like, that means my fingernail is in this scratch. Like, this is gonna take new paint. This isn't just a major, it's not just a minor touch-up job. I was gonna say, it's not just a minor touch-up job, it's a major thing, but it is a major thing. It's not a minor thing, it's a major thing. I cannot believe this. In all the years of RVing, it's a good thing I love that man. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you would like to see some more of the videos that we've got for newbie RVers and some tips for those of you that are newer, you can check those out right over here. And if you're considering renovation with your RV, we did a full reno on ours, and you can check out the whole series we did with tips on reno over here. And if we don't see you on the road, we'll see you in the next video.